class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai Education Department. I am Mrs. Akshata Kale and today we will learn EVS. Come on students, let us begin our lesson.
Of standard 4th and the topic name is Water Safe for Drinking. Yes students, drinking water must be safe for our health. Pure water has no taste, no smell or no color. If water has a color or a foul smell, one must avoid drinking it. It can make us ill, isn't it? Okay, today let us learn how can we convert impure water into a potable water following different processes. Okay? Yes, students, now we are going to make one experiment. Okay, now I have taken here glass and water and stirrer. Now I have put one spoonful of sugar in that and I am stirring that continuously. See, within some time, sugar disappears in the water. Means sugar dissolves in the water. Yes. If I tasted the water, this is a sweet water, isn't it? Okay, like that only we will take different substances. Now I will take then sawdust. Sawdust means wooden powder, you can see over there. And then a spoonful of salt. Then turmeric powder means haldi. Then oil. Alum, and then I will take sand, then washing soda. Okay, dear students, I have taken so many substances here. I will put one by one in the water separately. Okay, here you know that sugar dissolves in the water, isn't it? I will keep that aside. Then I will take sawdust and I will put in the water. I will stir it. No, sawdust remained as it is. It is floating. So it does not dissolve in the water. Now third, I will put salt in the water. Yes, salt disappeared. Means it dissolved in the water. Correct? Then turmeric powder. It gives color to the water, but it will not dissolve in the water. Means some of the substance that gives color to the water, but turmeric powder remains as it is. It settles down in the glass. Okay, the next thing is oil. Oil floats on the water. It does not mix with the water. Then comes alum. Yes, alum dissolves in the water and it disappears in the water. Then comes washing soda. Here also, when we put washing soda in the water and stir, then washing soda disappears. Means it again dissolved in the water. Then what about sand? Sand, you know that sand, it does not dissolve in the water. It remains as it is in the water. Yes, students. Now, from the given substances, we made two different lists, isn't it? Here, sugar, salt, alum, and washing soda, they dissolved in the water. Okay? Means they disappear in the water, and so they are called, they dissolve in the water. And for here, sawdust, sand, turmeric powder, and oil, they does not dissolve in water. Got this, students? Means from this experiment, we came to know that some substances dissolve in water while some substances do not. Okay? The substance that dissolves in water spreads throughout the water. When salt dissolves in water, the water in the container tastes salty. You know that when we put salt in the water becomes salty, isn't it? And when sugar dissolves in the water, water tastes sweet. Correct? Means, yeah, whichever substance we put in the water, water gives the taste of that substance. That is called solution. Solution. When a substance dissolves in water, a mixture of that substance and water is formed. This mixture is called the solution of that substance. See students, here if I put sugar in the water, we get sugar solution. Okay? And if I put salt in the water, we get salt solution. And here water is called solvent. Okay, dear students, one more experiment we are going to do here. Now I have taken some different substances and I have taken a half jar filled with water. Now I am going to put all these materials one by one in the water. We will see what happens. Okay, now first I will put groundnut shells in the water. See, please go on observing the happenings. Now next I will put coin in the water. Then I will put compass, metal compass in the water. Then I will put a stone, small stone in the water. Then I will put a iron nail in the water. Then eraser I put in the water. Next, a little twig of a tree I will put in the water. Then a plastic scale or ruler I put in the water. Then pencil I will put in the water. Yes, students, you can see here some materials, they are floating on the water, and some materials, they sink in the water. Can you see? Yes, here things that float are lighter than water. See students, here we can see a plastic ruler, groundnut shells, a little twig, a pencil. These substances, they are lighter than water, so they are floating on the water. Got this? And things that sink are heavier than water. Please see here, the eraser, the metal compass, iron nail, see that 1 rupee coin, and the stone. They are heavier than water, so they sink in the water. Got this, students? Yes, by this experiment, what we understood? Yes, here some things float on water while some things sink in it. You know that lighter things float on water and the heavier things sink in the water. Got this? Okay, now we will see what happens in different stages. Here I have taken a muddy water. You can see here muddy water in the jar. Okay. Now I will keep this one without touching for 4 to 5 hours. Can you see here? Slowly the mud particles moving down because they are heavier. Just now we did the experiment that in that we understood that the heavier particles move down or they sink, correct? And the lighter materials, they come up. You can see here small, the twigs or leaves, all they are floating on the water. Okay? Now again we will not touch, we will keep like that only. See now, the water is more clear than the earlier. And here also the heavy particles, they are sinking down. They are depositing at the bottom of the jar. Now after some time we can see like this. Here we can see the lighter rubbish or the twigs or the leaves, they are floating, and the heavy soil particles, they are settled down. So this process is called as settling. Got this ones? How we got clearer and transparent water from the muddy water? Okay, this process we have to follow to get the pure drinking water. But is it safe? No, because here we can see mud at the bottom of that jar, and the floating lighter rubbish particles, they are floating in the water. So we have to follow the next step. Yes, dear students, after that we have to filter the water. Yes, now here we will take one funnel and we will take filter paper. Otherwise we can take a cotton cloth folded into four layers. Okay, when we put water on that, the floating particles and the soil particles, they stay on the cloth, and the clear water moves down and it collects in the beaker. What this means, we got a clear water. Yes students, can you think, is this water suitable for drinking? No, this is not suitable for drinking. It is clear and transparent, then also it is not suitable for drinking. Why? We will see. Yes, microorganisms are present in that clear and transparent water. Yes, what is the meaning of microorganisms? We will see. New terms. Okay, micro means very very small, and organism means a living thing. Together it make microorganism, means a living thing that cannot be seen by the naked eye or even with a magnifying glass. For this we need microscope to see this. See this. Microscope is an instrument for looking at very very small things which we cannot see with our eyes or even through a magnifying glass. Yes students, I think you have seen this microscope in your laboratory. This is a microscope. Got this students? By this we can see the microorganisms present in our surroundings or in any substance. There are numerous kinds of microorganisms around us. They are in the soil, in water, in air, on rocks, that is anywhere and everywhere. Yes, dear students, some microorganisms are useful to us and some are very harmful to us. For that, useful microorganisms, here some examples I will give. Number one, we use a good or useful microorganisms to convert milk into yogurt. And we use useful microorganisms in the preparation of idli dosa batter, that is it helps in fermentation. And also in the preparation of bread we use microorganisms. Okay, and some microorganisms are very harmful, and when they enter our body they cause diseases. The good example is COVID-19 virus. Correct? This, when it enters our body, it causes the disease, corona disease. Correct? Yes, dear students, like that only, even if the harmful microorganisms are present in water, we are not be able to see them. Now, though the water with such microorganisms look transparent, would it be safe for drinking? No, right? Then what shall we do? Yes, here is one best method, that is boiling. Boiling the water kills the microorganisms in it and prevents diseases. This is easiest and best method to get the pure water, to make it free from microorganisms. We have to boil the water at least for 20 minutes. Okay? When it cools down, again we have to do the filtration. See here, students, this is filtration, you know. Here, that boiled and cooled water is passed through the filter paper or the cotton cloth. Then the clear, transparent and the pure water is collected in the beaker. Now, can you tell me, is this water suitable for drinking? Yes, you are right. It is suitable for drinking. This is called potable water. Yes, this is potable water. Yes, potable water. Potable water means water safe for drinking. Okay. Water that does not endanger our health in any way when we drink it is called safe drinking water or potable water. Got this, students? How we have converted the muddy water into a safe potable water. Got this? Always remember, even such tiny living things like microorganisms which our eyes cannot see have great importance in our lives. Children, we will take a quick summary of this lesson. Okay, in what we have learned today. Number one, some substances dissolve in water, some substances do not. Some things float on water, some sink and settle at the bottom. In order to obtain clean water, muddy water is allowed to settle. After settling, the water is cleaned further by swirling alum in it or by filtration. Even in clean, transparent water, microorganisms can be present. It is necessary to have safe water for drinking. So, water must be boiled to destroy any microorganisms in it. Right? Now we will go through the exercise. What's the solution? Here the question. Mother had brought some cumin seeds, means jeera, okay, from the shop. But some sand got mixed with it. Sand means here reti, isn't it? Mother wants the jeera seeds cleaned. Yes, dear children, what is the solution for this? First, we will go through the pictures of cumin seeds. See, these are jeeras, okay, and sand particles, right? Here, jeera is mixed with sand particle. Yes, what are you going to give the solution to your mother to separate these two things. Yes, very good. This is called sieving. Yes, by using here sieve, we can separate jeera from sand. Correct? Because sand particles are smaller in size than the jeera, isn't it? So here we can write, by using sieving method, we can separate cumin seeds from sand particles. Because of sieving, the sand particles, they pass through the sieve, while the jeera will remain on the sieve, isn't it? Like this, we can separate these two substances. Next is, use your brain power. Some rava has got mixed with sago pearls or sabudana. Rava, you know, suji, right? And sago means sabudana. What sieve should we use to separate the two? The one that allows rava to pass through, or the one that allows sago? Here, this is rava. Okay, see the size of the particles. And see, this is sabudana or sago pearls. Okay, now which type of sieve we have to use to separate these two? Yeah, you know that sieving method we are going to use here to separate these two. Which type of sieve? Means the one that allows rava to pass through, or the one that allows sago? Yeah, yes, you are right. Here the answer is, we should use the sieve that allows rava to pass through, because particles of rava are much smaller in size compared to sago pearls, isn't it? If sago passes through the sieve, then rava can also pass through easily. So we have to take the sieve that only allows the rava to pass through, isn't it? So that we can collect sago on the sieve. Fill in the blanks. Here we have five fill in the blanks. Okay. First we will write down these. Okay. Now first one, substances like salt and sugar dash after some time when added to water. You know this. You do this at your home. What happens to salt and sugar when we add these substances to water? Yes, they dissolve. Very good. Substances like salt and sugar dissolve after some time when added to water. Okay. Number two, the mixture obtained on dissolving a substance in water is called a dash. When you dissolve salt in water, that is called as, yes, solution. Very good. If we add sugar to water, we get sugar solution. Right? Third one, ORS is an example of dash solutions. Whenever the patient is suffering from dehydration, we use ORS solution, isn't it? So it is a useful solution. Okay? That helps him to recover. Correct? So it is a useful solution. Fifth one. Sixth one. Right? Okay, we will go through the answers. First one, all microorganisms are not useful. Some can cause. Yes. Very good. Disease. if they enter a body. The best example is COVID-19 microorganisms. Correct? They cause disease, right? Corona disease, if they enter our body. Right? Next, things that float in water are dash than it, and things that sink are dash than it. We know this, right? Some things they float on water and some things they sink in water. Why? Because things that float in water are lighter than water, and things that sink in are heavier than water. Right? Last one. A substance called dash is swirled in muddy water to help clean the water. Yes, the answer is alum. We use alum to clean the water. Correct? True or false? First one, alum powder does not dissolve in water. Dear children, tell me, is this true or false? Yes, good. This is false, because alum powder dissolves in water. We use alum to clean the muddy water, isn't it? Number two, microorganisms cannot live in water. This is also false. Microorganisms, they are in the soil, in water, on rocks, in air. That is, they are anywhere and everywhere. Right? Third one, if muddy water remains still, a sediment is formed at its bottom. If we don't touch, we keep the muddy water as it is for some time, we get the deposit or the sediment at the bottom of that vessel. Correct? So this statement is true. Next, an eraser floats in water. Is this true or false? Correct. Eraser is heavier than water, right? So it sinks. So the answer is an eraser floats in water. That is false. It sinks in water. Fifth, tea leaves can be separated from tea by filtration. Yes. This is true, right? Now we'll move to question answer part. Okay? Answer the following questions. First one, name the substances used to make the solution called lemon sherbet. Lemon juice. Okay? Lemon sherbet is oftenly made at your house, isn't it? First, we will go through the substances. See this, lemon, sugar, salt, a glass of water. When we mix all these in required quantity, we get a tasty lemon sherbet. Isn't it? Okay, we will write the names of the substances used here. Substances used to make the solution of lemon sherbet are lemon, sugar, salt, that is a pinch of salt, okay, and water. Right? Second, does oil float on water or sink in it? Yes, dear children, see this picture. Your yellow color that tells us that is a oil, and colorless transparent liquid that is nothing but water. This is oil and this is water. Yes, dear children, oil floats on the water, right? It does not mix with the water because the density of the oil is less than water. About this, you will study in further standard. Third one, why is it that water that looks clean and transparent may not be fit for drinking? Here also we have done one experiment on this, isn't it? Okay, we will write here answer. Water that looks clean and transparent may not be fit for drinking because it might contain harmful microorganisms, right? Because microorganisms, they cannot be seen through our naked eyes. We think that the water is clean and clear, but it is not safe for our drinking, right? When making a sherbet, what do we do to make sugar dissolve quickly? Yes, dear children, we are in a hurry. Then if you want to make sherbet quickly, means the sugar should dissolve quickly, correct? So what we can do? Yes, the answer is we can take number one, powdered sugar. Okay, means the crystal sugar takes more time to dissolve compared to the powdered sugar because the particles of the powdered sugar are smaller, right? Okay, that we can do. Or warm water we can take. In warm water, the sugar dissolves quickly. Okay, by using the stirrer, we can dissolve powdered sugar, or by taking warm water, we can do the sherbet quickly. Here we can write like this. We can take powdered sugar, otherwise warm water, to dissolve sugar quickly while making sherbet. We can use any of this. Okay? How can we tell that water has become transparent? You know the meaning of transparent. See, this is water is transparent, correct? Because it is clean and clear, and we can see other side through this water, right? Here we can write like this. When the water is free from floating and sinking impurities, it can look clean and clear. Then we can tell that water has become transparent, okay? But you know that it may contain the microorganisms, right?
Thank you very much for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon to get new updated videos.